Eastern. 7-6, 4-6, 6-4.
Leila Fernandez is through to the women's final at the U.S. Open, and Canada's newest teenage tennis star has the crowd at New York's Arthur Ashe Stadium on its feet. What a moment, and what a remarkable run. Along the way, Fernandez has beaten several top names, and tomorrow, Fernandez plays for a Grand Slam title. Well, for more on this, Matt Cullen of CBC Sports, and he joins us in Toronto. Good morning, Matt. Let's look at this. Leila Fernandez meet another rising star in an all-teenage final. History being set on so many ways with this story. Set up the championship match for us.
Well, good morning, John, and really a historic moment in tennis. First all over the place as Leila Fernandez will make her first ever Grand Slam final appearance. And what a run this has been. For the second time in 3 years, there's a Canadian, John, in the U.S. Open final. And the 19-year-old from Laval, Quebec, won her third straight match against a top five player. This wasn't easy, though. She fell behind in the first set and had to battle back, and her opponent, Arina Sabalenka, made a few key errors, and that allowed Fernandez to catch up and eventually take the first set in a tiebreaker. Her family loving it. The Canadian fans in New York City loving it as well. And frustration started to boil over for the number two seed from Belarus. This was a memorable moment full of rage and anger. But the Belarusian did manage to battle back. There's Steve Nash, great Canadian basketball player and coach of the Brooklyn Nets in the NBA. He knows a thing about winning or two, and that is exactly what Fernandez did. In the third and deciding set, she took the match and booked her spot in her first ever Grand Slam final. Now, this is remarkable, John, because number 73 in the world, no one saw this coming. This is a rise that is just truly amazing. And the big pressure moments, that's where Fernandez thrives. And she talked about how she keeps her composure in the big spotlight. Let's take a listen.
Well, that's years and years and years of hard work and tears and blood, everything on court, off court, sacrifices. And you know what? I just wanted to be in the finals. I really wanted it, and I fought for every point.
And it will be an all-teenage final, John, as you alluded to, because 18-year-old Emma Raducanu of Great Britain is also in her first ever Grand Slam final, a Canadian connection, born in Toronto, but grew up in Britain. It's the first time we'll have two unseeded players in a Grand Slam final in the Open era. So we are truly, John, truly in uncharted territory for this final match tomorrow.
Uncharted in so many ways, because we could see more Canadians make it to the final at the U.S. Open. Set up today's matches.
Well, more big matches today. You're right. Two other Canadians have a chance to join Leila Annie Fernandez in a U.S. Open final. Let's start with the men's singles. Felix Auger-Aliassime, 21 years old, from Montreal. He's playing against a heavy hitter today, Russia's Daniil Medvedev. So Felix, he has a chance to make his first ever Grand Slam final, much like Leila Annie, but this will be a tough match. Medvedev won their only previous meeting back in 2018, and he's also the number two seed at the U.S. Open. And Ottawa's Gabriela Dabrowski, this is women's doubles, her Brazilian partner as well. They also have a chance to make it into the U.S. Open final. Dabrowski, 29 years old, as I mentioned, from Ottawa. She's never made it to the U.S. Open final before. She made one in Wimbledon a few years ago in women's doubles. That match expected to begin just after 1 p.m. Eastern time today. So by the end of the day, John, today, we could have not one, not two, three Canadians in U.S. Open championship matches. Remarkable stuff.
Fantastic. Thank you, Matt Cullen in Toronto.